An apple weighs about 1 newton. The world record for jet engine thrust is 570,000 newtons, and the Saturn V rocket that launched people to the moon had a thrust of 33,360,000 newtons. But how can we measure forces this big accurately? Well, we need to ask this guy.
Hi, my name's Rick Seifarth. I'm a physical scientist in the Mass and Force Group. Am I supposed to look at the camera?
Sure.
Okay.
You can look at anything you like.
Yeah.
Rick manages a deadweight machine that can apply 4,448,222 newtons. Why such a strange number? Because that's exactly equal to 1 million pounds of force.
There are 50,000-pound increments in this machine. 20 times 50 equals 1 million pounds. Cumulatively, that's 4.45 meganewton.
Elsewhere in the world, are there larger masses that people have calibrated?
I ask that question to every visitor we get. And I've not gotten one response that says, yeah, I know where bigger stuff is calibrated. So if I really want to go out on a limb and brag, I'll say these are the largest mass objects ever calibrated anywhere.
The machine works like this. Below ground are the 20 carefully calibrated masses. Their weight is used to calibrate force sensors, also called force transducers, in the lab upstairs.
This is a 1 million pound capacity, 4.45 meganewton, and this is 13.3 meganewtons, 3 million pounds force. This is the biggest machine of its type in the world, and obviously one of a kind. One of these would be placed on the compression head right here.
Then a hydraulic ram in the attic starts to raise the green lifting frame. And once the force transducer contacts the red loading frame, well then it starts lifting the weights downstairs. And as the lifting frame continues to rise, more and more of the 50,000 pound weights become suspended by the force sensor. And since the weights create an accurately known force, the readouts from the force transducer can be precisely calibrated. These devices are then sent out into the field.
Well, literally, there's a test stand that's set up with one of these gizmos, a force transducer embedded in a test stand somewhere.
Fire.
And we have ignition of NASA's Space Launch System solid rocket motor powering us on our journey to Mars.
And so the rocket is fired up, perhaps ramped up, ramped down, and those forces are monitored. You know, the old movies you'd hear, oh, go to 104% of power. Well, how do they know it's 104% of power? Because somebody's measured it somewhere.
When it comes to minimizing uncertainty, these guys aren't messing around.
This piece right here is approximately 50,036.27 pounds of mass.
Approximately,
yeah.
Think about that for a moment. Each of these pieces has a mass equivalent to 10 minivans, and their exact value
is known to within several American nickels.
Just a few American nickels.
Yeah.
Were the difference.
Yeah.
That tiny uncertainty is measured with respect to the very definition of the kilogram, using K20. That's the United States Fundamental Mass Standard. This is done by comparing combinations of known weights, starting with K20, with larger unknown weights, gradually working up to larger and larger masses. For example, here a single 5 kilogram mass is compared to 2 twos and a 1. At some point in this process, they convert and start working in pounds, going from 50-pound masses to 500 pounds and then 2,500 pounds, and then using a scale in the floor to reach 10,000 pounds and then 20,000 and finally 30,000 pounds. Combinations of these huge weights are then used to calibrate the 50,000-pound masses which form the weight stack.
And we have to have that because what we sell is the vertical force vector that's generated by these weights hanging in the gravitational field. We sell that with an uncertainty attached to it of 0.0005%, 5 parts per million, so that means at full 1 million pounds of applied force, we guarantee that to be accurate, if you will, within 5 pounds.
Not only does that mean the masses have to be accurately calibrated, it also means the gravitational acceleration at this location has to be taken into account. It's actually slightly less than Earth's standard gravity, so an additional 600 pounds are required. Plus, the buoyant force must be counteracted. Since these masses displace 125 pounds of air, a further 125 pounds must be added to reach 1 million pounds of force.
What strikes me as kind of amazing is that, like, this machine needs to exist in a way. Like,
yeah, yeah.
When I would have thought about it, like, how would Boeing measure its forces, I would have thought, okay, they just, you know, calibrate a device that works, you know, up to X, but then they can, you know,
Guess.
Generalize. Well, generalize. You know what I mean?
Like, guess. There's an axiom that says one physical test is worth 1,000 expert opinions. And that has proven itself time and again, particularly in the world of physical testing. If you're getting on an airplane that somebody has built, are you willing to accept a 10% uncertainty on these numbers, or do you want it to be the uncertainty of these measurements to be down in the mud?
I think that's what you want.
Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock.